Students, welcome to video lecture series on computer networks. Today we are going to discuss about Berkeley sockets. Berkeley sockets are application program interface available in Unix domain. They are used for creating sockets in inter-process communication. Berkeley sockets provide a set of functions like creation of socket, listen to a connection request, accept the connection, then transfer data between them and finally closing it. So these are set of functions available in Berkeley sockets API, and here we can see a set of stages through which the client and server will undergo during connection establishment. Here we can see a set of two lines. On the left side we can see a set of dotted lines. This dotted lines show the server state sequence. And on the right side, we can see a solid lines. And these solid lines show the client state sequence. So now, let us check what are the state. Initially, both the client and server will be in idle state. Then, once a connect function is executed, the state is moved to active establishment pending. The connection establishment state is now in pending state. Once the server accept the request and establish a connection, the state is moved to established. Now, once a disconnect request is executed, it is moved to active disconnect pending. And finally, when the connection is disconnected, the client and server, they are moved to idle state. Now let's check the left side, that is server sequence. Initially it is also in idle state. Once the connect request is received on the server side, the connection is moved to establish. Before that it is passive establishment pending. Once disconnect request is sent, the state is moved to passive disconnect pending, and finally it is moved to idle state. So these are the different states through which a server will undergo during connection establishment and release phase. Here on the server side it is passive, and on the client side it is active because the request is initiated by the client side. Now let's check what are the different functions or primitives. Socket, bind, listen, accept, connect, send, receive, close. They are the different primitives. We will get more details about the various Berkeley socket primitives here. What is socket? A socket can be called as a connection starting point or an ending point. So creating a socket means create a connection endpoint or a beginning point by allocating various resources and assign an integer number to the socket. So once a socket primitive is executed, it is identified using an integer number, that is its number, and memory resources are reserved for the socket. Bind means the socket is associated with a certain IP address and a port number. Bind means once we create a socket, it is associated with certain application in a computer. So that computer IP address and that application protocol port number. That application has a certain protocol. If it is SMTP, it has got a certain port number. So that port number is associated with bind. Then listen. Listen is executed on the server side and it causes a bound TCP socket to enter into listening socket. So socket and bind function both are executed on the client side and the server side. Once it is executed, server will listen for any connect request from a client. Now connect. It is used on the client side and assigns a free local port to a socket. So client is executed on the client side and it assigns a local port number to a socket and it establish a new TCP connection. So connect is executed on the client side and it makes an attempt to establish a new TCP connection. Now accept, from the name itself it is clear, it is executed on the server side. It accepts a receive incoming connect request. Then send, receive are used for sending and receiving data between the client and server. And finally, close causes the system to release the resources and the connection is terminated. Here is the client side and the server side. So client side, initially a socket is created, then a connect primitive is executed. On the server side, a socket, then bind, then listen. Once a connect request is received, accept primitive is executed, then send and receive between client and server, finally close. So this is all about Berkeley sockets. Thank you for listening.